Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, Latanya. Good morning. Making sure I got my volume up here. Good morning. Good morning. All right. Well, let's just dive right on in. How about that? How about that? Thank you so much for tuning in this morning. I hope that you woke up excited about your day and ready to dive. And I can tell that you are because you're here, right? And I'm here too. So we are going to dive in deep, okay? On Tuesday, good morning, everyone. You all come on in here. I'm so happy to see you. And we're going to pick up somewhat where we left off on Tuesday. This is still very much in my spirit. And so God has given me some additional intel to share with you all in regards to the message. Sometimes you have to take the L part two. Amen. Good morning, Cynthia. Good morning, everybody. You guys come on in here. Sometimes you have to take the L part two. Okay. Now, on Tuesday, we established that the L we know is often referred to by the world standards as a losing symbol, okay? It's when you have majorly lost. You have dropped the ball. Stuff is just jacked up. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. You guys come on in here. Thank you so much. Okay, but what we established on Tuesday is that in the spiritual realm, the L does not have to stand for losing. It can actually stand for the fact that you are still a winner in spite of it all, because you have taken an L that represents learning. The negative has been turned into a positive. Well, on today, the Lord told me to deal with another L, okay? That's why it's called part two. The L that we're going to take a look at today is not learning, but it's actually leaping. Jackie B. Davis, I'm glad to see you, lady. Miss Ollie, I'm glad to see you. Oh, God, there's Dr. T. There she is. Good morning, everybody. Listen, today's L is not learning, okay? You all have gotten that lesson. The L that we're going to lift up this morning is the L that stands for leaping. Oh, God. How many of you know that every now and then in the natural realm, we really do have to take a L. We really do mess up. We really do find ourselves on the negative receiving end of things. And we have to make a conscious decision on how we're going to perceive it, how we're going to react or respond to it. And today, I've got some good news. The L, hallelujah, that is being dropped off, the anchor that's being dropped off this morning to encourage you and help jumpstart your day into the realm of faith, grace, and possibilities is leaping. My God, my God, my God. When I began to get this download on last night, truly something in my belly began to leap. My God. Hey, Sha. And listen, it's not for losing. It's not for losing. It's for leaping. And actually, I saw a quote last night as I searched around a little bit that said this, and I want you to take it in. It said that sometimes you have to take the leap and build your wings on the way down. My God. And that's a quote by somebody named Kobe Yamada. Sometimes you have to take the leap. The L is for leaping. And build your wings on the way down. So, leap. Let's deal with it. To leap is to simply jump from one point to another point. It's a sudden or a large movement. And check this out. It is to transition. Is anybody diving with me this morning ready to take a sudden leap, a sudden jump, a sudden large movement from one point to another point? Is anybody ready oh God, to not just talk about transition, but to actually be living out a positive, my God, positive transition. Yeah, listen. The other thing I want to lay out as a backdrop, if you will let me do that, is to build. Sometimes you got to take the L, you guys. You've got to take a leap over a thing, and you've got to build or grow your wings on the way down. Now, to build something means to make it stronger or more intense. It means to fortify it mightily and greater than it was previously, okay? Now, some people say, you know, especially when it comes to Christendom, it don't take all that. You know, you're fasting, you're praying, you're studying, you're sacrificing, you're giving, you're sowing, you're doing whatever you can do, my God, to obey and take the lessons that we talked about on Tuesday and learn from them, right? Some people might say, you know what? It really doesn't take all that. When you are in the process of building something, whether it be yourself, whether it be a structure around you, your own infrastructure, you know, fortifying and anchoring yourself from the inside out so you can withstand the fiery darts of the enemy. You know what? Nobody can tell you exactly what it takes, what measure or degree it takes for you to be able to get that win that we talked about on Tuesday, because I am talking to some winners on this morning, right? Yes, I am. So let me ask a question. What is it that you have a desire to be increased today? What is it in your life, in your scope, in your sphere of influence? What is it that you desire to see an increase in on today? Good morning, Paula. Thank you for joining us. What do you desire to see take a sudden jump in your life? What is it, guys, that you desire to see transition from one point, take a big jump, a big leap over, and be at another point? If you could wave a magic wand right now, what area of life would you see take an L, my God, take a leap? Oh God, you can ask God this morning. Good God Almighty, y'all flowing on in here. You can ask God today for that area that you've got in the forefront of your mind to experience an L, to take a leap today. Oh God, you can take the L, baby. You can take a leap. Let your faith cause it to take a leap. Let the words that come out of your mouth cause that area of concern in your life to take a leap today. You can take the L, but the L is in a positive mode. The L stands for leaping. Now, I talked to you all on Tuesday about the Scrabble game, okay? That was my backdrop. How a word was placed on a board and then it was built upon. And then a few rounds later, it was built upon even the more, creating a 168 point increase. I want to say to somebody this morning that you are in a fantastic position to build something, to leap in your life. The building is going to be a platform for you to be able to leap ahead of the spot that you have previously been in. Once again, to leap is to jump. I don't know about you, but I just literally heard in my mind's eye that song way back in the day. I think it was by Chris Cross. Chris Cross make you want to jump, jump. Hey, anybody ready to jump today? Anybody ready to see yourself, my God, moving freely, uninhibited, unhindered, unshackled, unleashed from one point to another point in your life? Well, let me show you something in scripture, okay? Luke chapter number 17. Luke, there's another L for you all this morning. Chapter number 17, verses 11 through 19. Talk about an amazing leap that is taken on in scripture, right? We've got Jesus on his way to Jerusalem, and he comes across what? 10 lepers, 10 men who are very diseased. They have a nasty disease that was called leprosy. And back in the day, if a person contracted leprosy, they were, my God, ostracized. They were contaminated. They were quarantined. They were commanded to stay away from everybody else. Sounds a little bit like COVID-19, doesn't it? Well, at any rate, Jesus sees these 10 lepers, my God. And verse number 14 says, when he saw them, after they called out to him, they met him, they saw him, they opened up their mouth, and they spoke some words that perpetuated, that kick-started, jump-started an amazing leaping in their present condition of sickness over into an area of healness and wellness and restoration. Let's look at it, okay? Verse 13, they call out to him, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. Have pity on us. And the Bible lets us know that when he saw them, he said to them, go, show yourselves to the priest. And as they went, they were cleansed. Now, what is this? In verse number 15, it says, one of them, when he looked down at himself, he was en route to go show himself to the priest. And when he looked down and he saw that the leprosy had disappeared right before his very eyes, oh God, as he was in transition, there's your word, there's your L, as he was en route, on his way, transitioning, he saw that his sick condition had taken a leap over into healing. He saw that the sickness had leaped off of his body at the command of Jesus to go and show yourself to the priest. This one leper came back to tell Jesus thank you. He came back and with praises on his lips, he threw himself at the feet of Jesus and he thanked him. He worshiped him. What does this have to do with an L, okay? Taking an L. I told you that the L is not for losing. It's not for losing. It is for your winning streak. It is for your winning position, your winning, oh God, posture. The L is for leaping. When these men saw that they were healed, and the one man, oh God, I don't know if he was the first one who noticed it, or the last. But what I do know is that when he looked and saw that he had taken a whole great big live jump, a leap out of leprosy over into, my God, being totally healed and restored, I can only imagine that he started leaping. He started jumping. He started praising God. In my mind's eye, I see him with his hands lifted up in thanksgiving, and he is not able to believe what has taken place while he obeyed and was in transition. Transition means to leap, okay? Now, what I want to say right here, my God, verse number 9 and 17, Jesus asked him, hold up, I see you right here, but weren't there 10 of you all? What happened to the other 9? Where are they? Has no one returned to say thank you? Two words, thank you, except this foreigner, this one man? What I want to say to you is what Jesus said to this man. In verse 19, he said to him, rise and go. My God, your faith has made you well. This man was the exception. I want to say to some amazing people diving with me this morning, continue to be the exception. Continue to be the one who keeps a praise on your lips and thanksgiving in your heart, because it will cause you to get a leaping anointing that suddenly, yeah, didn't I say leaping is to take a sudden or a large movement? Suddenly you will find that something has happened. Suddenly, as you are going, as you are praising, as you are worshiping, as you continue to believe, as you continue to speak life instead of curses, you will find that God has done a suddenly in your life, and he has built your wings on your way down into a position, a posture of praise. Are you diving with me today? Amen. Listen, I want to show you something further. This just astounded me when I was led to this in the Word of God last night. I want you to make a note about Psalms 18, verses number 28 and 29, just two scriptures here. We're continuing to talk about sometimes you have to take an L part two, but the L is not for losing, baby. It's for winning, and it's going to come in the form of leaping. My God, anybody ready to leap out of sorrow into joy? Anybody ready to leap out of not enough over into more than enough? Anybody ready to leap out of singleness over into fruitful marriage? Anybody ready to leap out of Lodabar over into Canaan land, the land that's flowing with milk and honey? Anybody ready to leap out of a state of confusion over into a state of crystal clear clarity that can only come when you get download from the Holy Spirit? Anybody ready to leap out of discord over into peace? Ha ha! Oh God, that surpasses all understanding. Is there anybody diving with me today who is ready to take an L? Ready to take a huge and a sudden leap, my God, out of one position over into another position? Anybody ready to stop being the employee and be the employer? Anybody ready to stop being barren and being full, have a quiver that is full of children, whether it be natural or whether it be spiritual? Is there anybody who's ready to leap? That's the L that we're talking about today. And I want to show you this in scripture. In Psalms 18, verses 28 and 29, David has been dealing with his enemies, okay? He's been running for his life. Saul has been trying to take him out at every turn that he possibly can. And David, my God, still has a song on his heart. Like the lepers, as they went, they were white. They were still diseased. They were still infected. But as they went and took Jesus at their word, one of them came back and said, thank you. Well, David kept a song on his lips in Psalms 18, my God, because God had delivered him over and over and over again from the enemies who were hot on his trail. Does anybody feel today as though the heat has been turned up in your life just a few notches? My God. Does anybody today have anything that you're contending with in your mind, in your heart, in your spirit, in your home, in your workplace, in your health report? Do you have any type of enemy that you truly need God to deliver you from on today? Well, I've got some good news. You're about to take another L, baby, but the L, it stands for leaping. Let me show you, okay? In Psalms 28, David says, you, Lord, keep my lamp burning. My God turns my darkness into light. Verse number 29 says, with your help, I can advance against the troop. With my God, I can scale a wall. Now, let me read this to you in the Message version, okay? It says, suddenly, there's that word again that means leaping. Suddenly, God, you floodlight my life. I'm blazing with glory, God's glory. I came to let somebody know today, my God, that God is about to floodlight your life. He's about to make the darkness go, make the darkness lift, loose, and leave. The darkness that you have been experiencing is about to take a leap out of your life and go into the desert where there is no life or light. My God, God is about to set you ablaze, okay? Yeah. And this, I can't tell you exactly what that means, but what I do know for sure is that he's about to do it. There's about to be a leap in your life. There's about to be a leap in your heart, a leap in your soul, a leap in your spirit. I feel it way down on the inside today that you can put some money on it. You can bank on it. Today is the 21st of October, my God. And listen, God is about to shine the floodlight. Now, there are all kinds of light. A floodlight, however, is a very large light. There's the leaping. It talked about a large and a sudden jump. The floodlight, to me, is almost like a spotlight. Illumination is coming to give direction. Illumination is coming to show the way how to navigate through the maze that you've been in. You think this is the way out, but oh my God, there's another blockage. You think surely when you go a little further, this has got to be the way through this maze right here, but oh my God, there's another wall. You keep going on, turning this way, turning that way, U-turning, rerouting, all of that like a GPS. With no signal, it just keeps spinning and spinning and twirling and twirling. And you feel a little bit like a chicken with your head cut off, trying to navigate through the ways that you find yourself in. Well, you know what? Another version I love of this, I believe it's the New King James Version. It says, by you, O Lord, I can run through a troop and leap. There it is. And leap. There's your L, baby. And leap over a wall. Leap over a barricade. Leap over the thing that's been trying to hold me down and keep me on the ground. You can leap over everything that's giving you disquietude, everything that's a buffet to your spirit today. You have been given a fresh anointing this morning to be able to take an L. But the L is not for losing. The L is for leaping, because you're getting ready to jump over this thing, okay? My God. Anybody ready? I want you to get your leg muscles ready. I want you to get your back muscles ready. I want you to start talking to yourself and telling yourself, my God, Psalms 30, I think it's 8 or 18. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. I don't know who I might be talking with who may have had a sort of a rough night last night. But you know what? I want to let you know that just as surely as it is light outside now, but when I first came down here and first got set up, it was black as night outside. That is the sudden type of leap that you can get ready to experience in your life. Now listen, that's how it's going to happen in the spiritual realm. You have got to understand that in the natural realm, you may have to walk through something that is called a word that we don't like too much, process. That's what happened with the 10 lepers, okay? The key words in that, Luke 17, were as they went. Somebody say that with me. As they went, they were healed. They were en route to the doctor's office. They were en route to go to the chiropractor. They were en route to go see the ophthalmologist. They were en route, and as they went, by faith, believing, even though at the moment that they began to put one foot in front of the other, they didn't see it. When they looked at their hands, they were still white. When they looked at their hands, they were still swollen. When they looked at their body parts, they were still deteriorating. But by faith, they took Jesus at his word, and as they went, to go and take that L. My God, I am almost certain that they felt like horrible losers. When you have leprosy, there's an L right there, Timothy. When you've got leprosy, my God, a nasty disease, nobody wants to be around you. Nobody can even hardly stand to look at you. You're stinking because flesh is falling off. Nobody wants to deal with that. Surely they felt and like they were in a losing season. Surely they felt left alone, the least of all, left out. My God, looked over. Surely they felt like it was just a done deal. I'm just going to be like this for the rest of my life, and it makes me miserable. I almost would rather go on rather than stay here and be like this. But Jesus heard them when they cried out. The Bible lets us know they said, Jesus, have mercy on us. And he did. He said to them, a two-part instruction, go and show. I want you, when we get off of here, to go stand in front of your own bathroom mirror. I want you to go and take a L in your bathroom or in your bedroom, in your full-length mirror, your wall mirror, your hall mirror, some kind of mirror. I see a mirror over there across the room on my wall. I want you to get in front of some kind of mirror today. And I want you to tell yourself, I might be taking an L today. But the L is not for losing. The L has received the super on the natural. And the L that I'm working with right now is for leaping. I want you to call out your name, Jackie Denise Avid. And I want you to say, girl, you better leap. My God, I want you to talk to yourself, Tim, and I want you to say, man, you better start leaping. I want you to see yourself like one of those lepers who were diseased, who were sick, who were deteriorating, who were not feeling this thing. My God, when you're sick and it's been going on and on and on, you're not feeling good. You're not feeling that situation and that circumstance. You're feeling miserable, but God is about to change some L's around. Instead of you, my God, losing, I want you to get ready to leap. Get ready to leap out of it. In the supernatural, it has already happened. Naturally, we've got to go through the process. So I want you to be committed today to go through the process. Sometimes when it seems you got to take an L in the negative sense of losing, it's got to walk itself out. It's got to run its cycle like a bad cold. It's got to run its cycle no matter how much medication and stuff you may take. I want to encourage you today that you're going to be all right. I want to say that you're going to make it. I want you to know today that God knows your name. He sees where you are. He sees the weights. He sees the situation. He sees the heart's desire that you have. Maybe nothing is so wrong at all. You just want more. You just want better. You just want greater. You see something else. You're ready to build upon what you've already started. Well, listen, God is giving out L's today. Leaping anointings. He's allowing us. He's going to help us be able to do more with less. There's another L. Do more with less time. Do more with less energy. And I want to say this as I get ready to click off because I just heard this. Taking an L, my God, and changing it around, turning it around from losing to leaping. As we said Tuesday, from losing to learning, take the learning curve, baby, and keep it moving. It will sometimes have some bumps in the road. It will have some hiccups. I got to let you know this before I click off. It will have some hiccups. Because one thing you got to keep in mind, the devil, the enemy, the flesh does not want you to win. They want you to not only take an L, but to keep on taking L's. The enemy comes to kill, steal, and destroy, per John 10 and 10. But God says, I came to give you an L. I came that you would have life. There's an L for you, baby. How you like that? I came that you would have life and that more abundantly. But the enemy is going to try to pull the rug out from under your feet. But you got to stand. The enemy is going to try to come and throw a brick through your windshield while you're trying to leap. He's going to be trying to block you and stop you. But you got to be determined to stand. Sometimes when you're trying to get those L's turned around from losing, my God, to leaping, from losing to learning a learning curve, the enemy will come in like a flood. But the thing that I want to encourage you to remember is that when that happens, you can't take down. You can't back up. Don't you backstroke now. I want you to dive with me, but don't you backstroke away from the point, the port that you're being called to out in the deep. Sharks are out in the deep. Squid, octopus, with all those tentacles are out in the deep. The whales are out in the deep. The orcas. They're out in the deep. But I want you to know that God said he would never leave you nor forsake you. When the enemy comes in like a flood while you're trying to leap over the wall and run through the barricade, God will lift up a standard against him. So you take comfort, okay? Remember that in process, there may be some rocky points. When those lepers were walking, at first, they were still debilitated. The first steps, the first few steps, they were still debilitated. Yes, they were. They were still limited. There's another L. They were still limited. They were still lacking all the strength that they needed. But as they went through the process, they looked up. There's another L. They looked up. They looked down. OMG. And they discovered that they had leaped out of one position of infirmity, limitation, lack. More L's for you. All the way over into being lifted. There's an L. By their faith, from a low state, there's an L. Shut up. From a low state to a healthy, restored, rejuvenated, better than ever state. But they had to listen, L for you, and they had to obey. And of course, they had to trust. And they had to believe, okay? Now, hallelujah, life. They went from low to lifted, Dr. T. You're absolutely right. So I want you all to know, it ain't over until God says it's over. It ain't never done until God says that is done, period. No matter what it looks like, you got to look up to the hills from whence cometh your help, for your help comes from the Lord. He's got your back. He's given a leaping anointing today to go with the learning curves from Tuesday. And I promise you, if you hang in there, let it run its course. Keep a praise on your lips instead of curses. Even if you got to cry and wipe your eyes and wipe the tears away. Even if you got to get the tissue and suck it up, dry the snot up. Even if you got to shake yourself and try to get yourself together. Whatever you got to do to keep believing, to be found living in faith, waiting, working while you're waiting. Keeping a praise on your lips like David did. You're going to be all right. Sometimes you got to take the L, but I want you to remember who's in control of the L's. Yes. Mourning is crossed out. He gives you dancing. Tears dried up. He gives you laughter and a smile. My God, my God, my God. Money stuck. He pulls a lever and makes it begin to flow. Oh, I thank God. I'm laughing. There's an L. I'm laughing. You know why? Because just when the enemy thinks he's winning and got you over a barrel and blindsided you, he's going to find out. The same way that God used Pharaoh to teach the children of Israel some valuable lessons in Egypt. And then after the lessons were done, he punished Pharaoh for being used against the children of Israel. God's going to use your enemies the self same way. God is amazing. Thank you for diving with me today. Have yourself a wonderful and a fabulous weekend. Keep looking up. Keep looking high. Amen. It's turning. I know it's turning. I know you're in transition. I know that you've been trying. I know that you've been striving. I know that you've been doing everything you can to keep yourself anchored and fortified and speak it when you don't see nothing. I know by faith that you trust God, and therefore God also knows it, and he's going to respond to your faith. He's going to respond to your faith as you go. As you go, he's going to respond to your faith. You're going to look down and you're going to be able to say one word, three letters, OMG. Amen. Thanks for diving. I'll see you next week. Bye.